Hey, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, traders, wherever you happen to be located out. We had another day where we didn't get any of our trades set up, but that's the case. Like I said, that the problem, well, not the problem, the wave of the system, it keeps you out of a lot of bad trades, but it takes a lot of patience, and it only takes one good day to make a whole week, and sometimes even to make a whole month if you really want to get crazy. But volatility will definitely pick up sooner or later, and tomorrow we have some interesting news out of Great Britain that could get things going. At least in the pounds point of view. But let's take a look at the majors, and then we'll just go through the pairs real quick. You can see that the euro pushed right up against this ascending trend line that we have talked about before, but could not gain any momo, so we're going to be watching that. And if we don't get a break of that level, it could be a good chance another 4-hour close. We can get a push at least down to the 132 level, just like we had a similar test and break lower right here. It looks like on the 31st, and you can see we've had multiple occasions where the same thing has happened. We had this on the 19th of last month, and then, you know, if we want to go all the way back to the very beginning. So this is a key level, and we're going to just watch it. If we do get a break, though, we could easily cycle back up, and we could be on our way up towards the 137.50 level over the long term. And one more pair we're going to take a look at the majors is just a USD JPY, because it's testing this 97.50 support level, and this 97.50 level is pretty important. If we get a break below the 97.50, 97, we could be down to the 97, 95 level, and this will translate nicely to our Euro JPY and Grapey JPY. I guarantee we will get breakouts that would pay nicely if we get that move. Let's see, the Great Britain pound, you can see, is still just consolidating in our fib levels like we have talked about. The 54.07 level should be key. Let's go through the trades. The Great Britain, New Zealand, no love. Once again, I was pretty sure when we got up here today at 4 today that we were going to get jumped into something, but you can see we did not. And with this consolidation up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, you can see that created a new low before we broke higher basically here. And you can see that the new level of watch is the 194.70 level, and then we just bounce bing, 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 and then we're going to close the level above this. But that's my new level of resistance, and this is actually an alarm trigger I have set there that if it had pushed back down through that, it would have set the alarm, would have made the trade. But we could not get the couldn't get a feel. The Great Britain JPY looked like we were going to get some love on this in the end of the day, but we did not. And the level I was watching wasn't this Asian low, because you can see the Asian lows have been just basically jumping around here. What I was really watching for was a break of this 150 level, just because the 150 level has been pretty strong support, and the pair has bounced off it, and we can go back on a much longer time frame. And that's what I was looking for. If we had a break of the 150 level, anyway, this is a better picture, we could have cycled lower and maybe pushed back down towards the 148 level over the short term. But in the near term range, you can see this definitely has been acting as a support level. So we're going to have to watch that, because we have because if we get a bounce at this 97.50 level, obviously the Great Britain pound is going to follow that higher into the move. And we have also, though, on Thursday, we have Wednesday night, we have about a bit of information coming out of Japan that could affect these pairs, and we might just be waiting to see that volatility, and then hopefully we might have to do some late night trading. But you know what, you have to find the trades when the trades are occurring in these slower markets. We've already looked at the Aussie, but the reason I would show you this is because, if you said, remember yesterday, I was anticipating that we were going to have, basically they stayed in line with their expectations and they just lowered interest rates a quarter point, but they did sound less likely to continue to lower their interest rates, and this led to a rally in the euro, in the Aussie. And you can see that the Aussie, normally when you have data like that, you get like a 15-minute candle and then everything settles down. And basically what we had is a break of the range in 89.50, and you can see that the pair moved up 50 pips or so and then consolidated the rest of the day. So what I'm saying, though, is that normally you have to wait for European traders to come in and we can get a little bit of follow through, but that didn't happen because I think all of Europe is on vacation this week. And the Great Britain odd, you can see same thing, same trade, just inverse. We get a push down lower and then a little bit of consolidation. I wouldn't be surprised if we move back up to the 172 area and just a slow grinding trade. And in the Euro odd, we already had that. We had the push down, and basically we went back right up to that level that we had to push down. But in both these pairs, you can see no trades opened up. up to us in the yen. We already talked about the euro, JPY. We're just watching these lower levels, hoping for a break of the yen pair to take us lower. And the euro, New Zealand, you can see in this pair that the cross looked as though we're pretty confidently going to get a break lower, and it just did not work out for us. You can see that we had a push lower here about at the 5 a.m. level, but when I was really but it was too close to there, so I was waiting for a trigger, and you can see that we had a cross back here, so I decided to hold off on that, and luckily I did, because this thing was just chopping all around without any momentum. But these things will clear up over time. All right, everybody, good luck trading. Just remember, keep patience, because patience is key. There's, you know, with trading, the one thing you have to keep in mind, it's not how often you're in the market, it's how profitable you are when you are in the market. All right, everybody, talk to you tomorrow.